about wishbiz.com and how nice that you want to follow along with this project, building my ultimate multi-power module. And we're already in part two, so let's take a closer look at the electronics involved. If you're new to this project, please rewind my timeline and find another video about the INA3221 chip. This is a board with a 3-channel current sensor on it that unfortunately needs to be fixed for this project, but in the end we'll have our own PCB with the SMD type INA chip on it. So let's take a look again at that wish list for the ultimate multi-power module. It supplies 4 voltages, 3.3, 5, 9 and 12 volts, and it works up till 1.5 amp at least. Most of the time I'll be below 1 amp, by the way. Voltage monitoring for 5, 9 and 12 volts, we let go of the 3.3 because that's not used that often, and we want milliamp precision in our current monitoring. So the 3 buses must be monitored, and it must have a resettable current peak on the display. And then our extra wish, we want a automatic fuse so we can configure the maximum current for each bus. And last but not least, a very small footprint. It has to fit in a case like this. This is a 3D printed fischertechnik silverlink case, and it's only 3.5 by 7 centimeters big. By the way, this is my Zauberling. For more details about my other experiments here, take a look at my other videos and do subscribe. The chip to monitor the voltage and the current is the INA3221. This chip makes it possible to measure the voltage across a shunt resistor for each of its bus, and it has 3 separate channels or buses. These are the shunts, and they go into an analog digital converter and can be read out over the I2C bus. But the INA3221 can do much more. It can indicate with control signals whether the voltages are within a valid range or whether the current exceeds a set limit. And it can warn when there are out of range conditions. The chip can issue a warning if it exceeds an average value. The critical alert of the chip is the most interesting for my application. This would make it possible to program a limit for each individual output voltage of my module. If more current is drawn, the automatic fuse trips. The great thing, of course, is that both these warning and critical values can be set from the software into the chip over the I2C bus, making it completely configurable from the front with push buttons. So there are 3 registers in the chip that you can set values to, and these reflect the limits that you want to monitor. Remember the 7, the 9 and the B register here? We'll get back to that in a moment. To fit into a Zauberling case, we have to split it into 2 PCBs eventually, so I've also cut the schematic into pieces. This is the part with the INA chip that does the measurements. This also contains the relay that will serve as an automatic fuse. This is the relay. So over here we have the 12 volts from the DC adapter coming in. Goes over a fuse and a switch to a voltage regulator that makes 9 volt for the system. This voltage therefore does not flow across the automatic fuse formed by this relay, as you can see, and this 9 volts only goes up here to board number 2, to PCB number 2, where the Arduino Pro Mini turns it into 5 volts and it comes back as 5 volts for the INA chip. And because it's on one connector, we can always stick a temporarily voltage regulator in there if we want to test only this PCB. Okay, so there are 3 voltages being created from the incoming 12 volts flowing across the normally closed contacts of the relay. The 3.3 going directly to the voltages and the front print. That's the second PCB that has all the connectors on it. And the 12 volt coming in from the DC connector over here, it goes to bus number 1, to shunt number 1 of bus 1 of the INA chip, and then it flows through PCB 2 and to the front connectors. Second holds true for the other one going over bus 2, that's the 9 volts coming out there. And finally the 5 volts over here is on shunt number 3, on bus number 3, and flowing to the other PCB over here with this connector. And these are the pins that are available on the front to connect your device and your stuff to. We already talked about the three registers that you can use to set critical values or out of range values to be monitored by the INA chip. That signal is coming out the chip over here, going to the Arduino, monitoring it, and it might trap the automatic fuse by this signal over a transistor from the 9 volt system voltage. So this relay will go on and the normally closed contacts will go open and none of these voltages will be generated anymore. But the 9 volt system voltage, of course, is still there. Alrighty, let's take a look at PCB number 2 as well. This is the PCB that will eventually be on top of the PCB sandwich in a moment. And it holds all the buttons, the display and the various connectors for the voltages to be used. So there you have your connectors on the front of this module for 3, 5, 9 and 12 volts. And this is the Arduino Pro Mini that's also on this top PCB. It houses also the display. The 9 volts, the system 9 volts is coming in here and it goes into the raw of the Arduino Pro Mini, making 5 volts from it. It feeds itself, but also the display, of course, on that PCB, and it sends it back for the INA chip and the other electronics on PCB 1. This is the critical line coming in. It's been read by D8 of the Arduino, and D9 is an output signaling that the automatic fuse has to trip, and then this LED will also be on. There are 3 more LEDs and those reflect the different display states, and this clear button can be used to flush or reset the peak hold of the current. With the set button we go to the current setting, the maximum current setting, and we have of course a 5-pin FTDI USB programming port to program the Arduino. Okay, so let's see if we can put some stuff on a breadboard now and get this thing working. Well, there you have it. The display is on there, the relay is on here, and the processor and the INA board over here. 12 volt coming in over a fuse. This is the green wire going to bus 1 of the INA chip board. And it also goes over here to the system voltage regulator 9 volts. Voltage regulator making the voltage for the Arduino Pro Mini. And its voltage regulator making 5 volts for the INA chip. This is a 9 volt voltage regulator. This is the yellow wiring, as you can see. And everything goes over the relay to these voltage regulators. This is bus 2 on the INA board over here, the yellow. So we have the 5 volts with red wiring going to bus 3 of the INA chip. And this is the blue wire, the 3.3, not doing anything over the chance of the INA chip, but going directly to the output. So we have 12, 9, 5 and 3.3 volts. I also have a 100 ohm big resistor to serve as a load. I can connect it with the orange push button to any output. For instance, 5 or this yellow 9 volt output, like so. And that concludes my breadboard for now. Let's delve into some software and see if we can write a basic sketch to actually read out all the values. I came across a library for reading out the chip. It is a library made by SwitchDog Labs. Does not contain yet all the things that I need, but we'll talk about that in a moment. For now, it's more than enough. I have my own divines here, and I've defined my own structure for a bus, so I can use that structure three times to store all the voltages and all the things that we're going to measure. I have to initialize that, and then I can say begin. Let's take a look at the main loop for this small sketch that we have. This is the main loop. Just does some reading of buses 1, 2 and 3, and I've made my own function over here to do that with mainly the functions that were available in the library, but we had to do some tweaking there. Well, that's about it. All the values are of course locked to the screen, to the serial monitor output. I do that over here, and then we do just a delay of 2 seconds so you can read the stuff. Everything has been communicated over I2C to the INA chip, so we have to include the wire library to do that. Alrighty, let's go and see if this works and if we can actually read out things. Well, the good news is we can! To the left you see some output of the serial monitor, and this is my breadboard with the INA board. And I have my load wire to the yellow 9 volt output. Take a look at the current now, it's 1.2 milliamps, and when I push the button, whoops, there it is! Almost 90 milliamps, and you see that it's also been reflected in the current of the 12 volt main bus, because the 12 volt is led over the automatic fuse and the other voltages are derived from that. Let's directly measure this 12 volts, the green line, this 12 volt bus. Push the button and there it goes, almost 130 milliamps going on there. Very nice, very nice. And when I release the button, of course, that sinks back to around 10 milliamps. Finally, the 5 volts, and also that one can be measured independently. So we have three independent measured voltages here with their own measured currents. So the next step would be to see if we can get that automatic fuse to work. Unfortunately, with the existing SwitchDoc Labs library, that would not be possible, because this library turns out to be a library that only allows us to read things, and we need to write to the three critical setting registers, number 7, 9 and B, as we saw a moment ago. So I added some constants and my own set critical alert value routine to do that. So now we can set the critical values for bus 1, bus 2 and bus 3 in our software, in our main sketch. So after the begin, I just set the critical value for bus 1, bus 2 and bus 3, and from that moment on the INA chip will monitor its buses and automatically flag its critical output when one of those currents gets higher than the configured value. This Arduino sketch, of course, is a work in progress. I'll include a link to it in the description of this video or on the accompanying page. For now, I've already fleshed out most of our wishlist in software, and here we have our INA board with the three shunts, our processor and our display, and let's turn it on. And immediately it is showing the 12 volt bus, the green wire over here. So that's been displayed and measured. Next screen mode will give you the 9 volt bus, actually 8.9 I see. And we have also a mode for the 5-volt bus. Please notice the little LEDs on top here. These reflect the different readout modes of the display. In the final PCB design, they will be positioned below the connector fields for the different voltages, so we can directly see which voltage is to be monitored on the display. And there is also a mode in which all the three buses are displayed on one screen, and I can switch it off. This is the 12 volt readout, that's the green wire. Let's switch to 5 volt, so we can try this resistor load. When I push the button, you see it peaks to nearly 50 milliamps we saw a moment ago on the monitor output. And it holds its peak, even when I release the load. I can reset it. So that works. And perhaps it's time that we try that for the main bus, the 12-volt main bus. Let's load that with a motor. So let's use this fischertechnik motor for it. And just connect it. There it goes. Well, nothing happens on the readout on the display for the 5 volts, but we have to go to the readout for 12 volt, of course. There it is. And it's peaking to nearly 50 milliamps on 12 volt as well, with this little motor going round and round. Actually, after the reset, even a little bit lower, but we can easily increase it by holding the motor, and you can see the milliamps go up over 200 milliamps there while holding the motor. And that will actually give us more than enough threshold to test the electronic fuse, I guess. Let's reset it. And now see if we can set a current limit so that the automatic fuse will trip when we hold the motor. Current limit for the 12-volt bus is 600 milliamps, and that's been stored in the EEPROM. So that's been held also when you power off the Arduino. And we can lower it with the left white decrease button. And once I've lowered it away from the 600, you see that it now says temporary, which means it's not yet stored in the EEPROM of the Arduino yet. But once we push the red button, it is, and it says so on the display. So now it's stored in EEPROM of the Arduino. And this limit is only 90 milliamps. So once we hold the motor, the fuse kicks into action, effectively powering off all the four outputs, and the overload LED is on. Without holding it, the motor consumes only 40 milliamps, which is way below 90 milliamps, so if we reset it, the motor will be spinning again. After a reset, we see 40 milliamps, but when we hold the motor, like so, the automatic fuse kicks in. This is a nice proof of concept, but not very practical, so let's push it back to a normal value. Let's give it a headroom of 550 milliamps, a little bit more than half an amp. Okay, the 9-volt limit is 1 amp, and the 5-volt limit is 1.5 amp. So when I hold it, that's still way within limits, so no problem there. Let's see which peak current we had. A little bit over 200 milliamps. And when you configure below the current value, of course, it switches off immediately. There it goes. Well, that's about it for now. In the last and third part of this video series, we'll see if we can design the two PCBs, design and 3D print the casing, and make the front plate for the module. We'll transform this experimental setup into a real product. If you liked it so far, I hope to see you there. Until then, happy hacking!